So ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. You don't have a chair. We have to help the lady here with the chair. Could someone do that? That would be very nice. We have an assistant over there. He's running as fast as he can. He will get you a chair in a moment, dear. Serhat, everything fine with you? You're happy?
Yes, I'm very happy.
Are you happy in here?
Or should I be more
close? Good. Brilliant. I think we're going to adjust everything as it should be. So, a warm welcome again to this press conference. So, Serhat, take us through your rehearsal.
The second rehearsal. First of all, welcome. I mean, I see very familiar faces from different countries. Thank you for coming. It's nice to feel that I'm not alone. That's really important. Thank you. The first rehearsal was on Monday, so and today we made the second one. It's the first rehearsal, it's always, it's the first rehearsal, it can't be the best rehearsal, but we had some good parts, some parts we had to correct, we had to change several things due to several reasons, but today, actually, I'm rather satisfied. Still, there are some things missing, that's why it's still rehearsal, we are not making the real performance. But I think me and my team, we are right now, we feel much comfortable after this one. What do you think?
Well, if I ask you, what would you like to adjust until the next time?
Actually, we have to work a little bit more on lighting because we changed even the choreography from the first rehearsal to this one. So it's very normal that the team has to learn it, the new style, the new choreography, the new positioning. So that's why the lighting will be different for sure. Today we didn't work on it on the right way. And with some camera angles for sure, because we have an up-tempo song, the camera movements are very important to give the rhythm to the audience, not only on stage we are dancing, but the people in front of the television, and they have to dance too. So this is the reason the cameras have to be a little bit faster in such parts. But I'm sure it would not be. We had a very good conversation after that in the living room. I'm glad. I think on Monday it will be perfect.
Like it should be.
Yeah.
it takes time to adjust to the stage, even if you rehearse your choreography, you know your positions, but still, it's a huge room and you know a lot of different lightings and a lot of different cameras. How many cameras do we have to find?
Oh, for me, first of all, I'm coming from television and I'm used to have a lot of cameras around me in my life. That's why I tell you, it is not easy. I will not say only my personal opinion. It's really difficult if you have 42 countries with 42 different acts, different camera angles. I mean, a problem to the Swedish television. It's really a difficult job, and they are doing
very well. Great job. Okay, let's take some questions from the floor. Gentleman in the light blue jacket there. You will have a microphone in a second.
Hello, Serhat. I'm Maciej from Poland, dobry wieczór Europa. After our interview, Dawid Woliński, your friend from Poland, posted a message on Facebook supporting you and asking Polish fans to vote for you if you pass to the final, because we can't, unfortunately.
That's why friends are poor, isn't it? I mean, I have good friends around in Europe.
How do you feel about that? And do you have
I will make a special video for my Polish fans and for all those supporters from Poland. But Dawid Woliński is also a very old friend of mine. He's a very important designer from Poland. And of course, I'm very glad to get his support from the country. Even Poland, it's not giving votes in the first semi-final, but it's really great. That's why I really trust to all my friends, to all the friendships I have in all those years around Europe and in the world. They are supporting me very well.
What kind of support do you expect from Turkey?
Turkey is a big country, and of course, it's there is a big Turkish diaspora in different European countries. But it's not only Turkey, several countries have diasporas in other countries, including Greece, Bosnia. I mean, this is something nice. Of course, my people will be supporting me well, and this is a very normal thing.
B being around, meeting people in the diaspora and other countries. How have you been on tour before Eurovision Song Contest?
Yes, I've been in 9 countries. I wish I could visit 41 all countries if I could have some time, because it's something probably very exciting to visit other countries with the reason Eurovision Song Contest. It's another meaning for me. I will never forget this musical time in this, those 9 countries. I was in Azerbaijan, Georgia, then went to Montenegro, Serbia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Albania, Greece, Malta, and Macedonia. They were so warm welcoming. Thanks all those countries to having me in the beautiful cities.
Sounds like you've been the busiest participant this year.
Could be. If you take a responsibility of something, you have to take it very seriously. And in my position, I feel a country, San Marino, is trusting me and giving me the opportunity to represent them as a Turkish singer. This is really a very big challenge, a very big responsibility. And I feel it on my shoulders, and I take it with big pleasure, and I have to do my best. This is the duty of any professional artist.
I think we have a lot of new viewers following us online now through our cameras. Could you please explain the song and how it came about?
I don't like to say the message of the song is this and that, because this is a very unique question, but it's always asked. No, actually, everyone, if you listen to the song, if you are watching me here on stage, what kind of feeling you get, this is the message for you. Every person can get a different message of the song. I cannot limit them. This is my message. You have to get this message from myself. No, we are all different individuals, and we all have different lives, different lifestyles. So I'm sure each of you is getting something different from that song. But the most important thing is, the song is the link between singer and the audience. I hope that we are creating a beautiful link between us.
Perfect. More questions from the floor, please. Yes, in the middle there.
Oh my God, you have so many pages. I'm getting afraid to ask questions. Oh my God. Yes, you are from?
I am Pascal Veltenaar from Eurovision Artist, the Netherlands.
Netherlands?
The Netherlands, yes. And actually, I have a question for Old Chanto. You composed the Turkish entry in 1987, and in comparison to 1987, what is the biggest difference with Eurovision nowadays? Thank you.
I wrote for 82 too, and I was also on stage singing in 78, so I must be one, I think I'm the oldest participant of Eurovision in this global arena. I haven't seen a big difference, really. It's the same, but in the ones previous, we were always together. Here we are not that together. We were always in the arena, and there were lots of restaurants, cafes to be there, and we were always with other participants. I like from 87, maybe more than 1,000 photographs with everyone. It's a big surprise when I look back. But it's the same feeling, it's the same culture. Not much difference, really. It's the best place to be for me. That's why that's the same thing again.
And you brought a souvenir.
Oh, yeah.
Brilliant.
So the press packs have changed.
So that's the press pack from back then.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Suitcase. More questions? Yes, here, in yellow t-shirt.
Hello. I'm Daniel from Sweden.
Sweden?
Not Switzerland, Sweden. When I hear your song, I'm associated to a pop group called Army of Lovers, a Swedish pop group.
I love Army of Lovers. I love the Swedish pop stars, it's really lovely.
Yeah. Have you heard?
Of course, I have lovers from Crucified till all the songs. I don't know very well.
So, I wrote the song.
So, I want to write a
bit of blues.
So, you've been listening to our lovers.
But just to be honest, I mean, it's always, there are such genres in music. So yes, this is the direction. This is nice. I mean, you can compare it even with Shirley Bassey, with Gloria Gaynor in disco times. You can compare with several things. But as a Swedish citizen, it's I totally understand you. Army of Lovers is a huge success from Sweden. And but it's, as far as I didn't write the song, but I like this genre very much.
Some of my friends say that you sound like Leonard Cohen.
Yes, that's true. So, oh my God, I'm the mixture. I'm not the first Leonard Cohen. What else?
That's why there are always influences.
Yes, it's not influences, no. Influences is something else. It can be something similar. It can, okay, you can tell, oh, it reminds me of something. But influence is something totally different. I'm on my way. And you are not quiet. It's the biggest compliment that you can make to me. I mean, you are talking about the legends of the world music industry. So that's why I take it only as a compliment, but this is not trying to copy of something. This is, your voice is developing with your life, but you have your voice from your birth on. So I cannot change my voice if it's similar to Leonard Cohen, or Leonard cannot change his voice. So that's why influence is something else, but there are people I really admire and I really like and I really appreciate.
Anyway, it sounds very good.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm not very wrong if I say that you are a very international act, the whole team of the delegation.
Yes, that's right. But I have to correct something. So many people at Eurovision Song Contest, they think I created this team specially for Stockholm. This is wrong, because even 10 years ago, I had this team with me. Olcay Çok is my best friend. We are working for so many years. Nektar Stirakis, my Greek lyricist, he can't be here, unfortunately, this time. But I'm working with him more than 10 years. I have German label somewhere. I'm a market more than 10 years, Italian manager, everything is actually. Belgian, French arrangers, is all. The team is already with me. My dancers, backing vocalists, I have always the team from France. So that's why it's a good feeling, and it's very important to bring all these different nations under the flag of the one of the smallest countries of the world, San Marino. I think this is the success of San Marino to come welcoming with open arms to all these different nations. And this is the motto, come together. I think San Marino did it very well this year. Come together.
Absolutely. Together. Absolutely. More questions from the floor? Yes, in the red, big one in the front. We'll have a microphone in a second there.
Hi, Serhat.
Hi, Christina.
Ciao. It's Christina Gentili from OJ Italy. We love you being here, representing San Marino. We also miss Turkey in the contest, as you know. Do you think that your participation could help a bit bring Turkey back to the contest?
Christian, first of all, you always brought me luck. Thank you for being here again. My first press conference, you were there all the delegation. Thanks, Italian OJI members, really, it's very lovely. And regarding Turkey, of course, Turkey is one of the most colorful countries in the contest. So we had a lot of success, victory, second, third places, and I'm very proud of that. And some of my friends, they participated as entries of Turkey. And I wish, really, I pray that my participation this year could give another opinion to the Turkish broadcaster to participate at this 2017, the contest. I will do my best. You can trust me, because the Eurovision Song Contest needs Turkey, and Turkey needs Eurovision Song Contest. This is a hope. You can be different.
Perfect. All right, back there. Just stand up, please.
Hi, this is Christian from ES United. I was going to ask you, how was it to work with Victor Laszlo? And if you were considered doing a duet again?
Listen, first of all, the last part of the question. To sing in duet is one of the most difficult things in music business. The colors of the voice have to match. Even by the picture, I mean, you are making photo shooting and you must both good together, look together. And that's why it's really, you have, we all have to choose our partners very carefully. With Victor, we had a fantastic song, Total Disguise, which is written already in lyrics and music by Olgiato. Actually, Olgiato has written all my songs, so I don't really have a composer in my life. So, Victor is, again, I mean, you know her from 1987, presenting this show in Belgium with very big earrings, maybe you remember. It was a very impressive, very beautiful woman and a fantastic voice. I was so glad at the time to make this collaboration, and the song really so beautiful, and it's became in several countries a hit. You can still listen after 10 years in so many countries, it radios in high rotation. With Victor, why not? It was a one song project, but I'm always open. We always hear from each other. Why not? Maybe we'll make a surprise after the Eurovision Song Contest.
That's all the time we had, actually. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Merhaba, Serhat, and good luck.
Teşekkürler, grazie.
And we'll have a photo opportunity against the